Hello learners, myself Dr. Rakhi Narula. Today I will give my presentation on space, grade and curriculum management in multigrade situations. Many of you might not be familiar with multigrade situations and multigrade teaching. You might have observed that in some primary schools a single teacher is teaching students of two or three classes simultaneously in one room. Such a multi-class situation is called as multi-grade situations. And the teaching strategies a teacher adopts in a multi-grade situation is known as multi-grade teaching. What are the needs of multi-grade teaching? The need for multi-grade situations or multi-grade teaching can arise due to various reasons. The important reasons are as follows. First one is enrollment-based teacher recruitment policy, shortage of required number of classrooms in schools, unwillingness of teachers to serve in schools in remote areas, teacher absenteeism, running of special interventions program in the school. How we manage a multigrade classroom? Multigrade teaching is all about classroom organization, student management, and ultimately the successful transmission of grade-specific curricula. It is your responsibility as a multigrade teacher to plan and organize your classroom to get the best results from the space and resources available to you. As a multigrade teacher, you are the key to planning, designing, and managing a range of both grade appropriate and mixed grade activities for children to keep them engaged in learning. Your efficiency and effectiveness rest on creating a classroom conducive to learning by developing exciting and stimulating activities ranging from group work to independent study. You play a central role in managing the classroom in the following ways. Planning the use of classroom space, especially flexible sitting arrangement for both you and your students. Planning and carrying out multiple lessons at the same time. Designing activities for students to keep them involved. Creating, arranging, and using teaching and learning materials. Establishing norms of behavior expected of students to keep them learning. Now, we discuss about space management. Space management is of utmost importance in a multigrade classrooms. Whatever space is available in the class have to be used for learning corner, activity corner, question corner, parents corner, students sitting, teachers movement, keeping blackboard and display boards, etc. While making space management in the multigrade classroom, you should ensure the following points. First one is students sit comfortably in groups without disturbing each other. Proper light and ventilation in the classroom are not blocked due to covering of windows with display materials or boards. There is an adequate space available for free movement of the teacher as well as the students between the groups when it is required. The students are also able to reach the blackboards and TLM corners easily and use these facilities with ease. The learning corners, parents corners, question corners, etc. are easily accessible to students for their use. Now, we discuss about sitting arrangement, how we manage our sitting. Generally, during teaching learning in monograde classroom situation, you make different types or patterns of sitting arrangement for students in order to facilitate the conduct of group work, self-study, and other learning activities. The nature and type of sitting arrangement in monograde situation may vary depending upon the need of different learning activities. But the sitting arrangement in multigrade situation has to be different from one in monograde situation. In multigrade situation, appropriate sitting arrangement is the primary requirement, not only to minimize distractions caused due to sitting of different classes in the same room, but also to create a climate suitable for effective teaching learning in terms of organizing different activities in different grades simultaneously. Sitting arrangement in a multigrade classroom may also vary depending on the need of different learning activities that you plan to undertake. In some situations, you may plan learning activities common to all grades that you handle. In some other situation, you may plan separate activities for individual grades, or you may plan activities which could be carried out in a small groups. Hence, you need to make sitting arrangements in multigrade situation very carefully and judiciously. Being efficient and flexible in the use of time. It means how we manage our time in multigrade situations. It is important to make the best use of time available when involving students in different activities. The choice and organization of activities are essential conditions for good multigrade classroom management. You should also have a clear idea about how to divide your students by both grade and age levels, and what types of activities are best for different groups. This will help you plan activities which suit multigrade situations. For example, in grades 1 and 2 may need more teacher support in addition to aids such as posters, charts, and artwork appropriate to their age. This is especially true for children who have not had any preschool experience. They also need to gain a firm foundation in early literacy and numeracy. And students who have difficulty in these skills need extra help because the students have just joined schools. In grade 3 and 4 may need more peer tutoring along with instructional guides and dictionaries to help them through their more complicated curriculum and ensure they continue their mastery of basic skills. Grade 5th and 6th require considerable teacher support and monitored independent study in addition to problem-solving exercise. This is especially true if there is an examination at the end of primary school that determines whether they successfully complete that level and can enter secondary level. To assist you in your teaching, it is often useful to delegate some classroom responsibility to students as class leaders, peer tutors, and helpers for your activities. These assignments can be changed regularly so that all students have some role to play depending on their particular abilities and skills. A job chart listening assignment with the name of responsible student can be useful in this process. The selected students need to be oriented and guided on how to lead groups and help their classmates ensure all group members participate in the assigned activities, discourage bullying, and help maintain harmonious relationships among students. These arrangements aim to enable the members of each group to learn together and share the result of their work with you, other groups, and other grades. Teaching effectively in a multigrade classroom. It means how we should deliver our lecture or how we teach effectively in multigrade classrooms. Once you start teaching in a multigrade classroom, how effective your teacher is will largely depend on how well you are prepared to handle multiple activities. The goal is to create diverse instructional strategies, both suitable to the curriculum content and based on the needs of your students. Management of teaching calls for you to strategically plan activities to engage the students through direct teaching with a peer tutor, in a small group, or in independent study. As noted above, every child comes to the school with the potential to learn, but also with a unique personality and set of needs and abilities. This means that you need to develop and implement teaching strategies that enable you to address the needs of each child linked to his or her age, maturity, interest, capacities, and capabilities. It will take time to get to know each of your students, but you can begin by trying to make your multigrade classroom inclusive and conducive to learning for each child and group. Now, how we adapt the curriculum and lesson plans. It means, what are our lesson plans according to our curriculum? Revisiting and redesigning the national curriculum to suit multigrade situation according to the number of classes to be combined together is essential for teaching the required curriculum content in a phased and continuous manner, and for making it appropriate to the cultural and socio-economic context of your school. What are the suggestions for this? First one is, select common themes from one subject suitable for all the grades in your multigrade classroom. Next one is, develop a flexible timetable for all the grades throughout the session on this theme. Next, develop daily lesson plans for each unit related to this theme with the help of textbooks and reference material as per the curriculum. Then we select activities linked to the curriculum that are to be conducted in the class. Then we develop relevant worksheet for individual or group practice. Then relate these concepts from the curriculum to examples from your students' daily lives. Finally, prepare quizzes to assess your students' mastery of the curriculum content. In a multigrade classroom, the curriculum is best delivered in an integrated sequence of learning activities. To begin, you can concentrate on a theme, not individual subjects or grade levels. This becomes the focus for all learning activities for the whole class. You can add to the effectiveness of the integrate unit by linking it to as many different learning areas as possible. You will need to take time to become thoroughly familiar with the content materials for each theme. Work with students interested in particular topic to explore this, as it facilitates their and your learning. It is also important that you are systematic in planning lessons and developing teaching and learning materials relevant to each of the curriculum units. Integrated approaches assume that multiple resources will be used by students during the course of the lesson. Textbooks will be one of these resources, but these will be supplemented by a variety of additional print, audiovisual and community and human resources, field trips, community speakers, videos, library books, newspapers and magazines may be used as resources if available in rural remote areas. Learning how to use a variety of resources to find information is one of the intended learning outcomes of integrated learning. when developing a sequence of learning activities for an integrated unit, you have to aim for maximum variety in the course of a thematic unit. Therefore, students in different grades will need to work as a whole class, in a small group, in pair, and sometimes it is individually. Students will interact with you, other students, members of the community, and various learning materials. The core theme and subtopics are seen as natural context for students to use and further develop their skills and abilities in language and literacy, arts, social studies, arithmetic, science, and creative arts. Lesson planning for multi-grade teaching depends on the number of grades combined in the classroom. But whatever the number of lessons plan needed per day, there are three stages of planning to consider, which are planning activities before the lesson, during the lesson, and after the lesson. Now, we discuss about planning for learning situation. You have already learned to develop plans for teaching learning, planning lessons in monograde situations. However, prior to preparation of plans for teaching learning in multigrade situation, you need to organize the classroom, make desired grouping of students, and create conducive learning environment, since these are essential requirements to facilitate subject teaching learning in a multigrade situations. For this reason, the plans for multigrade teaching are called the plans for learning situation instead of teaching learning plans or lesson plan. The multigrade teacher has to perform the following activities to plan for the learning situation. He or she will have to ensure first which grade or grades to be included in multigrade teaching class. Understand what type of grouping is needed to facilitate multigrade teaching. Then he or she should prepare weekly or monthly scheme of lessons in which indication will be made about which subject to be taught in which group or groups at the same time. Ensure proper seating arrangement of different grades students in the same classroom. Prepare or collect required TLMs in adequate numbers and keep them at the TLM corners. Prepare daily lesson plan indicating therein the objectives, methods of transactions that are learning activities, evaluation strategies, etc. Form small groups as per the requirement of the lesson. Earmark the TLMs for group and individual activities. Specify activities for introduction, practice, reinforcement, and evaluation. Determine the amount of time to be spent on each activity. Determine teaching time for each group or groups. Ensure that the bright children help the children falling behind, as well as the grade child of upper help the children of lower grade. Assign project to each group after a suitable time gap. Ensure conduct of individual activities. Devise evaluation strategies for assessing learners' performance. Thus, we can say that the planning for multigrade teaching calls upon the teacher to take care of all the assigned grades at the same time to ensure proper time management and to make his or her presence felt in the grades or groups. Now, let's sum up what we had read in our today's topic. Multigrade teaching is a situation where a single teacher teaches several classes at a time. It means in multigrade teaching, there are several classes. Multigrade teaching is a necessity due to various reasons. One is due to lack of teacher and classrooms. The teacher who is involved in multigrade teaching has to face many challenges. Special attention is given on four aspects for multigrade teaching, that is classroom organization, pupil grouping, use of learning material, and proper planning. Multigrade teaching is more effective by the appropriate seating arrangement. Multi-level teaching is related with the monograde situations. Some learning activities need to be planned to be applied to high achiever, medium achiever, and slow achiever students. Lessons need to be planned that every child will get involved in some learner activities. There should be opportunities for children to learn from each other. If a multigrade or multi-level teacher is innovative in teaching with the knowledge of his or her task and proper planning and management skills, successful results can be achieved through this system. Thank you, learners. Thank you for listening.